Hi guys, Mark here. As you probably know, that is very important if you like to grow on Instagram to be consistent. It includes also style how you edit your pictures. There are many styles like colorful, natural, black and white, teal and orange, but one of the most popular is Moody style. Today I would like to show you what you can do in Lightroom to get that Moody look on your pictures. Apart of that, I will show you what to do to save it as a preset, and you will be able to download those presets from my website at the end of that video as well. We can start right now. Okay guys, let's take that picture as the first example, and let's do firstly very basic corrections. So fixing the light, putting highlights down and bringing shadows up. Also clicking those lens corrections. And as we would like to post on Instagram, I'm just choosing right dimensions, 4x5, and making our horizon straight. If it was fast, please check my other videos. I explain it step by step what I'm doing. But anyway, right now we are ready for the further processing to get Moody look. So we should first of all focus on the blacks to make it a bit more flat. I will show you what I mean. So I'm going to tone curve and I'm marking 4 points. And I'm bringing up blacks. Not sure if this is enough, but please see. Okay, so you see difference. You see what is happening. So maybe even a bit more. And here also. Not sure if I would like to work here. Okay, it looks like contrast is changing. So no, right now I will keep it relatively flat. So you can see the difference. Okay, so it was one preparation. Part of that, definitely, you would like to work with the general exposure. But very often you would like to have some vignette, and also you would like to have the main subject a bit more visible. So what I'm doing, I'm clicking here. This is radial filter, and I will make her a bit more visible. So clicking 2 times on FX to reset everything, making sure that I'm working inside of that circle, and putting highlights down, shadows up, and adding a bit more exposure. I think 3 steps are okay, at least for now. And I'm doing a bit similar thing. Okay. And this time I would like to work outside of the circle. This is for our vignette. And I'm clicking 2 times effect, bringing exposure down. Okay. And making it a bit stronger. So I'm going up with clarity. You can see the difference. Okay. Yes, I would like to keep it centrally. Cool. So we did some changes and I would like to show you how it looks like. So this is before our, let's say, Moody modifications, and this is after. We have not finalized the work yet, of course, but this is the right moment when we can save our edition as preset. I showed you already how to create the presets in different videos, but let's repeat the process very quickly. So I'm clicking here this plus. I'm giving the name Moody 001. I'm creating new group, let's say Moody styles. Okay, and check none. What I would like to save is only tone curve, highlights and shadows, and a part of that lens correction. Maybe even that is not needed. So I'm focused on those both. Okay, so if you can see, if I will go to our previous picture, I mean the same picture but without those additions, and if I will go here to Moody style and we'll use it, so it will be exactly the same what we have. Okay, but anyway, I'm switching again. So right now we can think a bit more about the colors. So we are moving down till color grading section, and it depends on the picture and then depends on that what you would like to get. You can get different modifications. Generally, if you're not familiar with that section, you can focus on midtones, shadows and highlights. We will focus mostly on shadows. So whatever I'm doing here, it impacts shadows. I'm looking at the color what I would like to have in shadows. It is up to you, of course, but I think there will be something around blue. And I think this is too strong. So I'm clicking shift and trying to find right saturation for that. I think something like that could be okay. And a part of that, I may focus also on highlights. But here I'm not very sure. Okay, maybe very, very slightly. You can see here, if I switch off color grading, this is that what we had before. And right now, this is that what we have. We can also change the contrast for highlights. Maybe, yeah, I think it looks a bit better, at least for me. Okay, so you could see what we have done. So it was our picture ready for the further editions, and this is something what we achieved. Of course, this is not the end. You can stay with that if you're happy about it, but you can do other things. So I will show you one more. I'm getting back to our basic tools and I'm moving clarity. So you can see that everything around it's getting stronger. Unfortunately, also our model. If you're happy about such look, but would like to skin looks more natural, you need to do one more thing. You need to click here in adjustment brush. Let's reset it. I'm changing shadows a bit up because this is not natural how skin looks like right now. And I'm decreasing clarity. So decreasing clarity, bringing up shadows. I will do that quickly. So definitely you can do that much better than I'm doing. But you can see the effects. You need to be very careful about face, especially with clarity. But I think so far that everything is good. Okay, so I think for that picture it is enough. Of course, you can change further colors. You can change temperature, for example. And you can try to decrease vibrance if you would like to have less colors or increase it if more, but I think this what we have right now is quite good. Okay, so just to show you. So this is our reference photo and this is that what we got after. But if you're happy about the final effects, you can save it as preset also. So clicking again here, Moody 002, let's say final. And I'm checking more options. I mean that what we are doing, but what I cannot do, I cannot save the brush. This is absolutely fine because for different pictures, you will need to use it differently. Okay, so we have also the second preset. So let's try to use those presets on the different pictures. This picture has been just reframed. Nothing else. So I'm going to our presets and firstly I'm choosing Moody so you can see the difference. Everything is more flat, But as I would like to apply just final effect, I'm choosing the second one. So you can see before, after, before, after. Of course, if you are not happy, if you would like to have different white balance, etc., so we can do further modifications. Just in a few, but in a few seconds, we have similar look. So let's try another one. So again, firstly Moody and final. But here, for this one, I believe we need to do a bit more. I would like to have more contrast and clarity, so I'm changing that. I would like to have that picture much stronger. Also, I would like to move light only here. Okay, and maybe even a bit more light. No. Okay, and vignette is fine, maybe even a bit darker. Okay, so you can see, maybe not so easily, but this is what we've done. Let's take this as a reference. Before, after. Okay, so let's try to use our preset to something totally different. I mean, right now we can see landscape. This is the Alps Lake in Switzerland. I haven't done here any modifications so far, just reframed it. So let's start with our Moody look. Looks a bit interesting. And we can go to the final. I think final is not fully fine, as I don't like this color set. So I'm staying only with Moody. But per my view, this is too weak. So definitely I would like to add clarity. And this is something what I'm adding. A lot of clarity. Apart of that, I will add a bit of the haze so that picture become automatically stronger. Maybe also I would like to add a bit power to the sky. So what I'm going to the section HCL. If you don't know how it works, I have separate video about it, but I'm focusing on luminance for blue. So I'm going down and you can see how much stronger it is right now. And maybe I'm increasing a bit greens. And we try to find what works for yellows. There is a lot of yellow in grass and trees. Okay, so I think it looks quite interesting. But of course you are not limited to that. We can try something more. I mean, first of all, let's see the difference. So it was before, this is after. So you can see very big difference. I think it looks spectacular. This definitely not, but it was just pure raw. And right now I'm trying to set this as a reference and I will create the copy of it. Okay. And my copy will be here. Okay. So I'm editing only this part. So maybe you would like to add that picture, make this picture a bit more stronger. So I'm focusing on vignette and decreasing it, maybe even adding the haze. Okay, a part of that, maybe you would like to have different greens. So I'm going again to HCL section and switching from pure greens to something like that, and something what I definitely don't like. Maybe you'd like to change the color of sky. Okay, maybe there is too much light here. Okay, so we can move it down, and if we like, we can make our colors stronger or weaker. And guys, you can see the difference. So both pictures definitely we can call Moody, but the final effect is a bit different. Everything is up to you. I will save both effects as the presets and you will be able to download it from my page. Link is in the description. But if you are interested about landscape photography topic, then stay with me. This is something what I really, really love. And soon you will see much more videos about it. Thank you very much, guys.